and welcome to another broadcast of the Youth Ending Substance Abuse Program. My name is Paige Brookins, and I will be your host for this broadcast. I have with me Jay Gibson, who is a board member of CARE Incorporated, Margaret Brookins, who's also a board member and the chair for our Thanksgiving dinner and day house, and our community spotlight, Romarr Mayne. So for this session, we'll be talking about the theme of the season of giving thanks. We want to acknowledge and give thanks for the community involvement that we've had throughout the season as we're going into this holiday Christmas season, but looking back on Thanksgiving and how we had an impact as an organization within our community. So for CARE, Community Alliance Reinvestment Endeavor, I'm going to ask you, Jay, if you can give a little overview of what our organization stands for, when it was established, and what type of programs we offer.
Sure, it's my pleasure. The Community Alliance Reinvestment Endeavor, or CARE, was founded in 1984 as the community service arm of Holy Trinity Church of God here in Reading. And what CARE is mandated to do is to go into community and transform the community through various programs and initiatives, and to change the community one person at a time.
And within our program, we do provide many types of services. For instance, we have a day house, which is a lunch type of program, but also people come who particularly maybe not need that, but enjoy the fellowship and the communication and the conversation. So they will come during the lunchtime hours to not only just get a free meal, but also to get some fellowship.
Yes.
We also have a role modeling station, the House of Good Food. We provide a transitional housing facility for a single parent with children. And my favorite, the Youth
Yes.
Ending Substance Abuse Program, which is our youth prevention mentoring program. Our highlight for tonight within our CARE ministry is the House of Good Food, in which we just celebrated. I'm trying to think, that started in 1990, so that is...
At least 26 years
of serving dinner, a full-fledged dinner, the day of Thanksgiving.
Yes.
So I know, Margaret, you do a lot with that particular program as you are the chair for that committee. Talk a little bit about the purpose and how that came about.
Okay. I was just thinking, really, in regards to just being appreciative of the CARE organization, because CARE organization just offers a lot of amenities to the community of Reading. And one in particular that I have opportunity to work in is the community dinner. It's many facets I involve myself in, so but it's the community dinner, and really that is awesome. And it being there from the beginning, not having a full-fledged role from the beginning, but certainly being a participant, that program is started for the lunch, the meal actually started when there was a need for people who did not have a place to have a fellowship meal or a meal period on Thanksgiving Day. And as a result, CARE involved themselves with seeing to it that these the people that had needed a meal were served. Also, it's my understanding that the Meals on Wheels was not provided on Thanksgiving Day. So as a result, that also became a part of the community dinner. So right now, like Jay had stated, going back over the approximately 20-some years of serving, we are now serving over 500 meals
yes.
on that particular day by way of delivery and by way of those who are coming in-house to eat that meal. And truly, it is a blessing to be a part of that organization on that day, to see all of the volunteers who call us from the city of Reading, who want to be a part, have some input, who don't count it robbery or denying themselves at that time from being away from the families, but they come and they just happily serve and happily work and happily prepare the meal. There was a young man who came recently. He said, "Is all of this food prepared here?" I said, "All of this food is prepared here." And so it's just really, really nice to be a part of the volunteers, to be a part of CARE with just so much involvement in the community with this community Thanksgiving meal.
Yes, and one of the things I know many people talk about is that the food is not pre-cooked food.
No.
That's right.
Everything is made from scratch.
Yes.
You know, so we take pride in what we serve, and it's good food.
It's really good food. And like you stated, it's all made from scratch. And it's just really, I see the happiness of the people as they prepare this. I mean, there's so much joy. And that's why I'm sure all of the folks who eat it enjoy it so much, because it's made with happy hands.
Mm-hmm. We're cooking approximately like 30 turkeys.
Yeah, at least.
So at least. So turkeys. So.
Yes.
So one of the successes within this particular program that we have and why it continues year after year is because we collaborate with many organizations, and that's a part of the season of giving thanks.
Yes.
Giving thanks to the community members, as you stated, who come year after year, the new ones who hear about the program and want to come in. And sometimes we have so much help that it's more than what we need, but we don't turn anybody away because we all have a responsibility in positively impacting our community.
Yes.
So we try to use them in any capacity, whether it's delivering the meals, whether it's taking the forks and rolling them up in the napkin, giving someone a coffee or anything.
That's right.
We try to use them.
And answering the phones when the people was to call in, and just even there to greet the people as they come in, shake hands, just show themselves friendly. It's just so much that's involved in it. And it just, as they said this time, they said, wow, it went so fast. But it was in terms of just the people getting together and just participating with this particular meal.
Yeah, as we talked about, we have different areas within CARE that we provide service, whether it's youth, whether it's the elderly, the one without a job. And you know, our community who are not involved in that particular program might ask themselves, how do you get involved in the different areas of CARE? I'm going to talk a little bit about that, you know, how do you get involved and in what capacities potentially could people work in if they choose to.
Well, the easiest thing to do is make contact with our office, and we'll give that number at the end of the program. Just, you know, giving up your time, your talent is definitely needed. There's always something that you can do. The needs are great in the community, and again, you don't have to feel that you have a lot to offer, that you're super talented. Just come and be willing and be able, and that's most of the challenge. It's getting to give of yourself and to be willing.
Absolutely. So one spotlight, our community spotlight for tonight, I'm honored to have him on our broadcast for this evening. One, because he has grown up within the YES program and is now giving back, not only with our community organization, but in the community of Reading at large. I hate to say he's a graduate of, no, I'm joking, as I'm a graduate of Westchester and he's a graduate of Shippensburg, so we're all from the same state system family. But Romarr Mayne, thank you again for making yourself available for tonight. As I stated, you have grown up in YES. You came here young and you jumped right in, one of those kids who are very energetic about the program, and you have a lot of talents, and you're a ball of energy in the sense that you're able to draw people. And that has carried on throughout your adult life. And one of the things that I question, and some of the people who I question who have gone through our particular program and are now successful, positive citizens within our community, what have you learned in your time with the YES program that has helped you and has been instrumental in your success as an adult?
Absolutely. Thank you, Paige. Well, first and foremost, to highlight, I was one of the first class of the YES program. So I think one thing that I did take away from YES is that to always put your best foot forward, try to be the best individual that you can be and not be impacted by negative peer pressure. I think that was one of the biggest messages that were put across. Growing up through the system from elementary school, middle school, through high school, there's lots of distractions. You know, you're meeting people from different, you know, demographics, different backgrounds, and it's so easy to get sucked into what's popular, what's fun. But I think the message that we did get, going through that program is, you know what's right, you know what's expected of you, and you just always stick to that. So I really attribute a lot of what I've, accomplished in my life to not being able to give in to negative peer pressure and learn that from, yes.
Absolutely. One of the things I think is challenging at times for our young people is the fact that they do get into the wrong crowd. And it's hard for them to be able to stand up, as you stated, from the peer pressure and kind of deny that activity and them having to stand alone at times. So I'm going to say for you, you're a college grad. You know, you have achieved that goal that many young people want to achieve. As you prepared yourself from elementary to high school and now accomplishing that goal of being a college grad and now a professional, a young professional, how do you, or what's some advice in the sense of education with what students can do now to achieve that goal in their future?
Well, absolutely. So, just going back and looking, 10, 12, 15 years ago, when YES first began, we didn't have the monthly activities that you guys do now. But what I did take away from that is that some of my good friends now came from the YES program. Three of us actually attended Shippensburg University from the YES program. And back then, though we only had it through the summer, going into the school year, you made those friendships and those connections, and we kind of kept each other, accountable. On weekends, we weren't going out and, with everybody else. It was, okay, let's get together, ask your mom if I can sleep over. And it was always that positive influence. And it's even a greater advantage now because they get to be around each other once a month and not just for the summer period. And my advice to you is that, you are a product of your environment, and I was able to, grow up with people and kids that went through the YES program and that had that positive mindset. So I guess my advice to you is that, surround yourself with people who want to succeed, who want to get an education. Right now education is not the cool thing to do. It kills me when I log on to social media and I see who's not in school. That's the thing to post. Who's not in school? I'm like, why? And everybody's, preparing to gather. But, back then it wasn't like that. So I guess my advice to anybody that is listening is that, surround yourself with people who have that vision of making it to college. College maybe is not for everyone, but making it to a technical school, going into the service, but they have a goal. Okay, so I guess that's, surround yourself with people that have a goal.
Good. And I apologize to our audience as we didn't explain what the Youth Ending Substance Abuse, or as we call it, the YES program, is about. It's a drug-free program for youth of the Berks County area, ages 8 to 17. This program was established in 2001. It provides educational activities, opportunities, as well as alternative, or as we would say, drug-free type of programs, where we're exposing them to things that they normally would not be have connection to on a day-to-day basis. For instance, some of them have never been to a college campus. So we try to take them to expose them to this environment so that they see that that goal is attainable. We also try to incorporate service type of activities as we inform our young people that it's not always a hands-out type of mentality, but also what you can give of yourself, as some of our activities incorporate that, and we incorporate that into our curriculum working with them. And as Romarr stated, back then when he started, it was fully a summer program. Well, we have expanded that, but the sad part about it is our young people don't take advantage as much as they should with the program being in the school year. So we meet very heavily in the summer program, giving them another alternative to the negativity, negative influences, but then we also meet in the school year. In the summertime, it's on a Tuesday and a Friday or Saturday. Tuesday is that educational piece where we inform them you have to come on that Tuesday to receive the education in order to be available or in order to be
eligible,
thank you, for that Friday or Saturday activity. And then in the winter months, we mix it up with both educational, cultural, service type of activities. And one of the things that is so important is free of charge. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So there is no hesitation for parents to be able to sign up their youth to be a part of this program, because it's nothing out of your pocket other than allowing your young people to be a part and to learn and to grow and to mature and have, as Romarr said, those positive influences around him or her to help them to be a positive contributor and a product of positivity within our community.
Now, before you go on, I just would like to say that it was truly impacting on me to see Romarr come on Thanksgiving with a carload of youth, mm-hmm. and their objective was to deliver these dinners to senior citizens. And these children were very encouraging to me to see how they came with just a desire. I mean, they weren't grouchy. They was eager to help. It was obvious to me that they were not dragged. You know, they wanted to come and go out and deliver these meals and participate in the delivery and of the services of any kind as far as it was asked. So that was really encouraging to me.
Very, very much so. And I know Romarr in the past has also been a spokesperson or a guest speaker at some of our events, as he has had some trials and some things that he has overcome. And he wanted to share his story, which was also very instrumental in helping our young people to have a reality check of what is out there, but how you can get through it. Mm-hmm. So I appreciate you in that sense. So for the Care Board, or just some question about what advice do you give to parents of our young people today?
Well, thank you, Paige. One thing I would ask is the parents, bring your children. Again, it's free. There's no barriers to your child's participation. You can come and bring that child, just drop them off and let them take part in something that's positive. People say, there's nothing going on in the community and blah, 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 but there is a lot going on in the community. There's a lot of positive things going on in the community. And yes is one thing that, there's no cost, and you can have the children can be involved in very enriching activities and programs, and things can impact them, just not that present time, but also in the future as well.
And I would like to say it's really, there's a lot out there that wants to draw and entice our children. And sometimes I know it may be a struggle for parents to say, channel their children to positive, because that's not necessarily where the kids want to go. They want to go to those areas that would give them a little bit more freedom in negativity. I just would like to encourage the parents to prod and push the children, the ages are 8 to 17, to be a part of the care program. As Jace had stated, the teaching that the kids get is teaching not for just today, but it's teaching for tomorrow. The directives that they get is directives that is going to impact their life, their goals, choices that they make in life, you know, the things that they aspire to do. And so I just encourage the parents to prod their kids and bring them to the YES program. You have people there who are certified already to teach them, people there who are already just looking forward to the opportunity to just pour upon these young people some positive instructions. So you have some people there that are just willing to help the young people. So I just encourage the parents, please, by all means, let them be a part of the care program.
Yes. There's also consistency too. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. There's also consistency too. You'll see the same faces.
Yeah, yes.
Most of them be a little more grayer and more slower. But for the most part, we've been there since the beginning.
That's right.
So again, the kids
right.
see us, they know us, and again, we.
That's right.
And we see watching Romarr grow in the
yes.
program, and others, countless other young people go through the program.
Yes.
And that's important. It's consistency, not a lot of this in financial volatility. And but again, there's people, there's familiar faces, and people who are invested in the community's welfare.
Yes, yes.
It's very rewarding, not yes. just for the participants, but for us as mentors.
Yes.
And that's the advice I would give to parents. to be a mentor. You know, be positive. Be that role model for other young people. Mm-hmm. You want your children to be modeling the positive, so you need to be that positive role model mm-hmm. as well for some other children and for your own. Mm-hmm. Yes. So that's what I would, and that's my whole dissertation. Mm-hmm. You know, mentoring in the urban community. How many of us, if we think about in our lives, someone took the time with us?
Yes.
You know,
yes.
Someone took that time to unleash the potential. And how we have grown, and now we're able to give to someone else. So for parents, that's the same thing. It's a cycle. Mm-hmm. And we need to make sure it's a positive cycle as we are working in our community.
Yes.
Romarr, another thing that I would say is that I commend you on is that you have been a mentor and continue to be a mentor. Currently, you work with Albright College in their track program. Mm-hmm. Correct? And you've done the same thing at Reading High School.
Yep. So I am an assistant track and field coach here at Albright College, but I also, in the summer as well, I am the sprint coach for the Reading Youth Track and Field Program. So that's also another, you know, outlet that your kids can get involved in as well. And I just think it's very important that we give back and let the youth of today know that there are more options than just the ones that are presented to them. Because so often you see the kids in our city just fall to, you know, bad decisions. And, you know, it breaks my heart because I also work with the Reading Recreation Commission at the pool. And these are kids that I see day after day. And then we go into the winter months and it's just so sad, you know, just to see them taken from us. So I definitely think that positive role models, you know, go a long way. And that's why I continue to give back in the community because that's what I grew up with.
Okay, great. So what to expect as we're moving on in these winter months? Some upcoming activities. For this December, we're doing some Christmas caroling to the nursing home, showing our elderly that we love them and we care for them and bringing some cheer and joy throughout this Christmas season. For January, we're going to be celebrating the life and continuing the dream of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. And then in February, we're having a cultural event. Mm-hmm. So again, we invite our young people in the Reading community, Berks County, ages 8 to 17 to be a part of our program. We are free of charge. We are located at 130 West Buttonwood Street, Reading, PA 19601. You can also find us at our website at caremeetsneeds.org, or we're on Facebook as well. You can email us at yeswecare01@yahoo.com. Again, I thank our panel for being a part of this broadcast for tonight. Mm-hmm. I appreciate you guys taking the time. Mm-hmm. And I definitely thank our community members mm-hmm. for making our Thanksgiving meal such a huge success. And to our community spotlight tonight, Romarr Mayne, thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you for what you are doing and currently and continue to do within our community to be a positive role model to our young people as we instill the values and the morals and help them to reach their goals. Yes. So thank you for that. Again, if you choose to reach us, please do so. We are looking forward to collaborating with you and your organizations to make our community a better place. So thank you again for tuning in. And we appreciate what service you give that we can make Reading a better place. So how do we spell success?
Y-E-S.
Thank you and have a great night.